Of all places, in front of Christini's, some freakishly cold winter's day, I had on several unflattering layers of wool. He slipped on the ice with his grocery bags full. So I rescued some Fruit Loops he dropped by the curb, and he made some remark that my smile was superb. I thought that was sweet and I started to go, and he said, "Hey, what you doing tomorrow? Because I'll be here on the corner of Bleecker and Mercer tomorrow at 7. If you want to meet up, I'll be waiting right here. And in case there are two fellas waiting for you, my name's John." He waved and then he was gone. Needless to say, I went back there to meet him, mostly to see if it shone. And there he was out in the cold with his jacket pulled tight. He took me to dinner and kissed me goodnight. The next week we went to this terrible play, and the week after that drank hot chocolate all day. And then suddenly 8 or 9 months had flown by, and he said, "Hey, what you doing the rest of your life? Because I'll be here right beside you as long as you want me to be. There's no question. There is nothing I've wanted so much in my life. This might sound immature, but I'm totally sure you're the one." And we had just begun. We got hitched in September, our favorite month, with a rock band that played in this old synagogue. And we bought an apartment on West 17th Street, and we talked about children and getting a dog. Our first anniversary came in a flash, and we promised to take the day off. He had to step into his office that morning, and so I went walking downtown to this bakery I know, when I heard on the street what I thought was a joke, till I noticed the sirens and saw all the smoke. So I'm running back home with this feeling of dread to the voicemail he left, the last words he'd said. "I'm sorry. I don't mean to ruin your evening by bringing up all of this stuff. You're probably wondering why I even called you tonight. Well, today something happened that spooked me, all right. I discovered his Fruit Loops still there on the shelf, and I cried, and I couldn't get hold of myself. But sure as I breathe, I heard John, clear as day, saying, 'Hey, you're allowed to move on. It's okay. Because I'll be here. Even if you decide to get rid of my favorite sweater. Even if you go out on my birthday this year, instead of sitting at home letting all of life's moments pass by, you don't have to cry. Because I'll be here when you start going back to the places we went to together. When you take off my ring and you let yourself smile. When you meet somebody handsome and patient and true. When he says that he wants to be married to you. When you call him one night and he meets you downtown, and you finally answer him, 'Yes, yes, Jason, I will marry you. I will give you my heart. It has taken so long, but I'm ready to start.' Right now, John's whispering congrats in my ear, 'cause I finally let myself tell you that I will be here."